Hello everyone, this is the Prussian Prince with another Total War Arena video. Joining me we have Maximus Decimus Meridius.
Hello!
And you can check out his YouTube channel, of course. He makes a lot of Total War videos, and by a lot, I mean a lot.
I think I have the most videos now of anyone on Total War.
Very likely, yes. And yeah, I'll put a link to the channel in the description, but anyway, that's not what we're here for. We actually are here to show you the replay system of Total War Arena, or well, like, not the replay system itself, but a replay of the game, which includes some barbarian units as well, but it's just some, mainly some lower tier ones. Anyway, should we start going over the builds?
All right. Have you already pressed play on the replay?
No.
I have.
By the way, this is.
Okay, I'm paused at 8:48 then.
Okay. 8:48, but I mean we can go with the builds first. But yeah, this map is Rubicon, and it's one of the new maps. I guess we will see this map in the next patch, maybe. Well. Obviously, I don't know what's going to be in the next patch, but I'm guessing it's going to be in one of the next patches, if not the next one. And as you can see, it's quite interesting because it has two towers, one on each side, actually, which does provide quite a lot of vision, but they are different in the sense that the Red Alliance has a tower which actually gives them cover because they have like this little grass next to the tower, like around the tower, which they can use to hide in. Whereas the Blue Alliance, they don't really have that when it comes to their tower, but what they do have though is like a lot, and I mean a lot of ledges.
It's going to be so hard to push this tower with skirmishers on these ledges.
Yes.
Like, there's room for at least 4 units on these ledges, maybe 5.
By the way, I'm paused at 8:29. I got a little bit too fast.
Okay.
And the engagement actually already started, but yeah, just go to 8:29 and pause there. Yeah, it's
but the map is fairly interesting. It's a very rushy map.
Yeah.
Like, the bases are extremely close to each other.
Rushing the center is going to be very, very hard though, because you have to
suicide.
Cross, and then you'll just die to like missiles or something.
Yeah, there are for the blue team. There's a great position here on the ledge.
But if it somehow happens that the enemy units don't have anything in the middle, then you can just go cap the enemy base. But that's unlikely. Could happen in random games. Who knows?
And there are these ledges all around the base as well for ECD capping.
Yeah, I mean, you have a lot of space behind the bases.
Yeah.
So, it's fairly interesting. Like, this is... There hasn't quite been a map like this one yet in Arena. Like, it's very unique in a lot of ways.
There are some great artillery camping spots here. So, fire straight into the enemy base.
I hope you're on 8:29 and post.
8:28 and post.
Okay, I'll be 8:28 as well, and I paused. But yeah, let's go over the builds. I guess we can go over the Red Alliance first. And let's start with VG Dane McConha, who's on the left flank, Red Alliance. And he has, let's see, he has his general unit in a Levy Rider and 2 Levy Tribesmen. And by the way, his general is Arminius. He's a barbarian commander. And he has some interesting abilities. So he has... Wait, I don't actually see his abilities though. This is...
Because it's paused.
Yeah, I guess it's because it's paused. But yeah, he has like... His ultimate is Infiltration. Which makes your unit sort of like appear to the enemy as an ally, so like it gets like the blue little blue overlay and stuff compared to the red one. And it's very interesting, but I'm not sure exactly.
But does it show the name of the player controlling the unit?
Yeah, so I mean, the efficiency of that is questionable, I guess, how effective it is.
Because imagine if you have two clans, the clan people are never going to be able to use those abilities. You will have Agony Prussian Prince sneaking around with one blue unit. And the enemy already knows you're on the opposite team.
It's agony.
Yeah.
But and we will see, though, because the least it's going to do, it's going to buy you, I think some other people mentioned it before, Duck, that it's going to buy you, 2 or 3 seconds, at least. It's definitely going to buy you some time, even though it's not very much. So we'll see if that's actually gonna be enough time for you to actually do something with it. So that is his ultimate, infiltration. Then he has an ability called Frenzy, which increases his melee attack by a lot and decreases his melee defense, which is
down to zero essentially.
Yeah, which you have to be really careful with. Because if you could just literally lose your unit very quickly if you misuse it, but sometimes it's really worth it and helps out.
If you manage to rail charge and you use Frenzy, that can do a lot of damage, and together with momentum as well, I think, because if you manage to disguise a unit, you use momentum to increase the charge impact and speed. And then you're able to get in and use Frenzy. I think you can. I've tested this a bit, and I've had some 1v1s in Arena of all things, and I've tested this, and then units start disappearing if you time it right. If you don't time it right, your unit is the one that's going to disappear.
Yeah, but momentum is very interesting in that it actually, currently the way it's implemented anyway, it actually just. Keeps going forever until you charge or you stop your unit, essentially. So you can just activate it in the beginning of the battle, and as long as your micro is good enough to always keep your units on the move, you will not lose that momentum speed bonus, because it's not gonna get deactivated because you're moving.
But what's the cap for the ability? How high does it go?
I don't actually know, because I haven't gotten it to tier 10, so unaware. So that's an interesting ability as well. And then you have Scout, which increases your visibility range and decreases, I think it was attack or something. But
yeah, melee attack.
Yeah.
Nice for skirmishers.
Yes. Or light cav or something, I don't know, if you're trying to scout out the enemy for your artillery.
Yeah.
Something like that. Probably people are not going to use it for that, because, I mean, unless it's serious custom games or something, because people want points in in random matchmaking games, so they can grind quicker, right? Although, I guess some people play for the win as well. I mean, it just depends. People have different philosophies. Or some people play for both. Whatever. But, yeah, that's basically Arminius out of their way, his abilities. But yeah, let's go over the build of Dane McConha again. So, like I said, 1 Levy Rider and 2 Levy Tribesmen. Both types of units are tier 1.
So we have tier 1 Cavalry Arminius, but they are... if you expect to use these guys like Citizen Cavalry, you're going to be disappointed, because they are not nearly as powerful. They are light, so they're very quick. And they only have 32 men per unit.
Mm-hmm. So... currently, they don't have a unit charge ability, but Barbarians do have a unit charge from tier 2 onwards. So, you know. For all the units, actually. Tier 1 Barbarian Swords don't have a charge. Tier 1 Barbarian Cap doesn't have a charge. But tier 2 onwards, they definitely do. At least unit charge.
And it follows with the tier, so the charge becomes more powerful the higher tier the unit is.
So... yeah, it's interesting how the tier 1 units don't have a charge, but yeah, that's basically Arminius out of the way, so let's CDR units. So here I'm playing, as you can see, with Scipio, with Triple Hastari. I'm just trying something out. And yeah, Scipio actually did get changed. I guess Oath is slightly weaker now, but that is to counteract the fact that he gets a charge on his infantry, I guess, and that Oath was really powerful to begin with. Like, it was insane melee defense. We'll see how much it's gonna play out though, because at tier 10, I believe you still have at least 200% extra.
But it's basically slashed in half. The Oath is basically slashed in half from what I've seen.
Oh. Yeah.
But you get an increase in charge deflection, which I don't think you got before.
Yeah, that is new, which is very nice. So, in fact, it depending on what you're fighting, it could actually be better if your melee defense actually maxed out anyway against some targets. But yeah, as you can see here, I've got 3 Hastari. And Dane Makaha has a unit on the tower. His cavalry to cap it, but then if we look at the center, well, more like center left, well, actually, it's still pretty much left flank. We have Spyro with Supreme here. Supreme has, again, also barbarians, 2 woodsmen, so that's tier 2 axes. Fairly interesting units, they have really nice AP. And 1 levy rider, which, as you can see, is already dead by the looks of things. As for Spyro, he does have this Tarantine cavalry over here, which seems to have either it's me or the unit card of it changed.
I think so too.
Yeah, it definitely looks different. But yeah, Caesar also received like a lot of changes. The main one is like VD, but I believe Divide and Conquer also changed. So like VD no longer gives like the insane missile damage boost it used to. It actually doesn't boost that at all. But Divide and Conquer, I think before it didn't deactivate while if you got damaged, it still didn't deactivate as long as you didn't move. But now, if you get hit by something, I think it also deactivates. So I think that's a new change to Divide and Conquer.
Well, Caesar basically got a lot weaker. Like the age of the Germanic scouts is over.
Yes, yeah. That is definitely true. But yeah,
now they only have increased targeting, increased radius. I mean, increased vision. But no increased range, no increased damage. Decreased deployable time. I don't know how useful that is, but
I mean, we will see how it plays out. Definitely, he can't carry the game anymore. That's for sure.
Nope.
Doesn't have anything to carry with. He is a support now, though, I guess. Like a real support.
Yeah. But
anyway, the rest of Spyro's units, as you can see, he has this Architecti here. And also some Velites up front, which are very far up front, actually. They're in pillar range of Mecha Chomp at the moment.
And look at these defenses they've set up here. 3 barricades,
yeah.
2 levels of wooden stakes.
Yes. So something interesting, by the way, to note is that the infantry units can now also deploy stakes and barricades. That is a change. Obviously, all of this can like be completely different for when the patch is actually released, but this is how it currently is at the moment anyway. But yeah, it's interesting that infantry units can deploy these stakes and barricades, but I'm not sure about it. Like, we will see how it plays out.
In terms, it makes sense, but I don't think it's good for game balance.
Yeah.
Because currently, one of the issues you face is that people will tend to camp, and there are many advantages to be gained from camping if you have the right army. Now, if every single unit can create stakes and barricades. That's going to promote camping even more.
Yes, I think so as well. So let's look at the other units. Wow, this is taking a long time, but at least we're being thorough with it.
Yeah, very much so.
So we have...
Well, this is the first replay, so it's nice to be able to talk about the changes and not just watch the battle, because there are a lot of changes.
So Riddick here, he has 2 Pionian Cav and 1 Thorax Hoplite with Alexander. So let's see... Alexander also got changed. Anvil is now has like a much shorter duration. I think it's like 10 seconds or something. And I wonder if anything else got changed. Yeah, Wedge is now a toggleable ability instead of like it disappearing on its own after a set amount of time.
That's nice, actually.
But I don't think that Hammer and Rapid Advance got changed, but I didn't really look closely, I guess. So yeah, that's another change. And then here we see Grimbro with Leonidas and 3 Thorax Hoplites. So this is interesting because Leonidas got a rework. So his push ability was removed in favor of Fight in the Shade, which means that he now gets... like, essentially it's the Raised Shields of Germanicus, except it's actually slightly better. It gives more missile block than... what the Germanicus' race shields used to give. And then we have a nice little house, so with 3 Velites as well. On the right flank we have Majutsu with a Helot Slinger on the ledge here, and a Thorax and a Citizen Cavalry. And that's basically the Blue Alliance. I don't think I missed anyone. So basically,
Nope.
Holding down the fort on the right against like 2 players, it seems. But yeah, do you want to go over the Blue Alliance now?
Yes. I'll start on the blue team's left. They have the Watchtower. We have OTP Pan G4P with Caesar. He has... Italian nobles, and then he has Principe, I think, yeah, Principe. 2 Velites. Then we have Morcai with Scipio. He has 2 Principe, 1 Hastati, 1 Triaria, I mean. Then we have Campy, Mechachomp, and there's Dr. Scott here. they have set up shop with multiple barricades and stakes. This is going to prevent any kind of push from happening in the center, unless units start moving around here, but that's of course going to be difficult, taking fire the entire time. Then we have over by the little house on the hill, we have Paul SS. He has 2 Citizen Cavalry with Alexander and 1 Thorax Hoplite. We have Yi Xer, I love these names. Yeek Ser with 1 Hallowed Slinger, Leonidas. Leonidas also has 2 Levy Pikes, or are these Hellenic Pikes? Hellenic Pikes.
Yes.
Then by the Vineyard we have Saint. He has 2 Tarantines, 1 Principe. A Mighty Muffin is bringing Caesar, and he has 3 Architecti. They were about to get charged by some Tierborn Cav in the beginning, but they managed to get into the Vineyard. And I think that was the entire blue team.
Yes. And by the way, like, we actually forgot to mention the changes for Germanicus. So basically the one thing that got changed is that his he lost his Raised Shields ability and gained another Testudo. He gained the defensive Testudo, which gives a lot of bonuses, but makes the unit not able to see anything, and it loses all attack capabilities for the most part, as you can see here, but it becomes insanely tanky against like missiles or cav charges or whatever kind of charges, basically. So it's interesting, but you do lose a lot of visibility and attack. So if you use the Studo, if you use that kind of the Studo, well, both the Studos, I guess, what you want to make sure is that there's somebody else around spotting for you, I guess. because you will have like no vision by yourself, essentially.
Anyway. Just to sum up the commander changes before we hit play here, in my opinion, Scipio got the better of the deal. He got an infantry charge. He still retains his good abilities. Leonidas got shafted. Push was the best way for him to stop the charges. But now he can't do that anymore, and Caesar is no longer the king of skirmish. He's just the king of being a bit less powerful than he used to be, I guess. Yes. The Roman skirmish is already weaker than the Greek skirmish, and I fail to see how the Roman archers are going to hang with the Greek slingers when they don't have any abilities pushing their damage and their range up.
Yeah, we'll have to wait and see. But maybe maybe the Germanic scouts will definitely not match up to the task, but maybe the Iberians will do okay. We'll see.
Yeah.
But yeah, I'm at 8:28, so
me too.
I'm going to unpause in 3, 2, 1, go. So as you can see here on the left side of the Red Alliance, Dane Makamha is engaging. He's actually dying on the pikes though, right now.
Dying very hard on the pikes.
Yes.
But tier 1 melee against tier 5 pikes, pikes down, that wasn't going to go well.
Yeah. Now he's gonna send in his cavalry as well, but... And I think I'm moving up here with my units. I'm gonna try and peel up the pikes, I think.
Your team lost a lot here. Supreme getting better engagement with his woodsman. He's actually doing well against Thorax Hoplites here. He's doing a lot of damage. But
look in the center. A nice little house got both of his javelins charged by Paul's citizen cavalry. Lots
wow.
of damage right there.
That was harsh. But now the citizens get hit by Spyro's Architecti, and these Architecti are doing massive damage to the citizens.
Wow, they're firing very nicely at him and quite quickly, actually. Massive damage. And the javelin's still alive, will shoot the cav as well.
But I think it was worth it for Pauls to get those skirmishers off the field. Nicely done.
So, again, on Maju's flank, though, which is like the right side, the Red Alliance, nothing really is going on. He's just holding there and skirmishing with his helots. He actually did a lot of damage to that Principis. The more interesting engagement, though, is on the other side, where, as you can see, I've actually started engaging with like my Hastati here, and I popped Oath. I'm trying to get Paul's cavalry here, also peeling it. And at the same time, then Dane McConha actually got into the helots of Ser, which killed a lot, and he's getting into their Architecti with his Levy Riders, so that's nice, for sure. And yeah,
he's killing them very effectively with the tier 1 Levy Riders.
Here I'm about to get killed by the pikes though, as they got there, but I'm also trying to flank them, but he does actually turn the pikes around just in time before I charge him, and now I'm gonna get charged by this Principis, so that's not gonna be good for me, but I will activate Oath though, so that's gonna help out a lot that I have another unit. In the center though, as you can see, the engagement is still continuing. We have the javelins that are unopposed, they're killing heavies, which is what they're meant to do. And how's the other flank looking, Maximus?
Over by the right, there is not much happening. There's a unit of Citizen Cavalry charging into Majutsu's Citizen Cavalry. They're going to lose there. A bit of a push going on from the Tarantines, getting chased away by the Citizens of Pauls. The lack of any kind of ability to fire behind them means that they will just be running away forever, basically. And one Citizen Cavalry here is routing two Paeonians. Majutsu still just holding the ledge.
Yeah, he's doing a very nice job there. He's targeting that Citizen Cav down, and it's taking massive damage from his Helot Slinger. He's also activated Heated Clay, which increases his damage as well. But yeah, not as much happening over there. You can see though that he's got, yeah, he actually has a Citizen Cav, like, in the back of the Blue Alliance here. He could be going around and just hitting their rear. And Dane McConaughey actually killed nearly all of the Architecti with his levy riders. As you can see, they have 2.5k points, so he did a lot of damage. Now Pulse is trying to get to those Velites in the center, and he does get in with his citizen cavalry, but one of them is still alive. Now it's gonna get engaged though. But yeah, it's starting to not look as bad for the blue team, actually.
They are behind in terms of manpower, but that doesn't tell you anything about what they have left. There are some units here that can get knocked off the field in a single charge. Like, the Levy Riders are still alive for Dane Maconia. They could get into another Architecti unit. If they can see it here, I don't know if they have vision, because they just run straight past it.
They don't actually have vision.
Yeah, because they're in the... in the grass.
Yes. And as you can see, Mechachomp is now retreating to his flag, because he does notice that their right flank has actually crumbled, and he's gonna have to send units to start defending the base. But the push in the center that they're doing, or rather the defense of the push, they're doing a very nice job there. They're flanking Grimbo right now with a lot of units. He is dying.
Mujutsu is also about to be caught here in the center if he doesn't move his slingers and his cav.
Yeah, he does get charged, and he loses a fair amount of HP, and now Pulse comes in with another charge. Very nice.
Very nicely done.
Yeah. And Mujutsu is trying to pull out, but he's losing so many of his men.
Yeah, this engagement is basically over.
So, yeah, not looking so good for the Red Alliance anymore.
Nope.
Despite winning our left flank, the center did not do as well in the right. Seems like
it's dead even in terms of points, but you're getting into some a Mighty Muffin here and his Architecti, but they run away into the vineyard.
Yes, and we're also chasing, trying to chase him away, but like, he's just being fairly annoying with his Architecti at the moment. But Mujutsu is holding with his Thorax Hoplite at the moment. I think he hasn't used Anvil yet. No, or he... no, he can't use Anvil, actually.
And Pulse is going to break him, probably.
Yeah, but we don't have many men left, actually.
No, he turned around, so he didn't get shocked, actually.
Yeah, that is true. He's doing the best he can with the unit right now. It's using defend, so it's actually got a melee defense buff at the moment. Dane Maconha is still alive. I mean, I'm trying to cap the enemy base, but I'm not gonna be able to do anything because there's like literally this Principis unit right next to my Hastari at the moment.
Got the Wrath of Mars charge in there. Did a fair bit of damage to his Principis, but you're so depleted. Yes. And taking fire from some Velites.
And I'm medium and he has a heavy unit, so...
yep.
Can be a pretty massive difference on the charge. But I can't actually see the Red Alliance's points, but our points... as you can see, I did a fair amount of damage, but Dane Maconha did the most. He killed a lot of the artillery pieces, as you can see with his Levy Riders. He's still killing them.
It's amazing that this unit is still alive.
Yes. It's a tier 1 cavalry unit and it just killed so much. Despite not having a charge. I mean, it's
this is the problem I see with the deployables. Have you noticed how many units have routed and then routed into the deployables? Like, say goodbye to your units if they route and you have this set up in front of your base.
Yes, they will not make it back to the base.
Nope.
But that's quite funny how they actually just route to... like, should they not know that there are deployables there just trying to go around? Like
yeah.
Dude, we don't care, we're running away from the enemy, even if it means our death, we'll go through the stakes. They're so afraid of dying at the enemy's hands that they would rather just suicide.
It's like they commit Sudoku on the pikes, on the spikes instead.
But yeah, that was the game. First replay cast of Total War Arena. Woohoo!
Wait, so, it just dropped me out of the game, so yes, now you're looking at my mail.
And I'm looking at my black screen on my recording. But
in future recordings, we're not going to be as thorough as we were in this battle. Then it's going to be straight to the action, I think. Yeah.
And again, bear in mind, all of this can change because it's not the official patch. But yep, hope you all enjoyed. Don't forget to comment, rate, and subscribe. Follow me on Facebook, Twitter, and Google+. Share the video. Subscribe to Maximus as well if you haven't already.
Please.
See you next time.
Strike them.